Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I'm going to check a bunch of new frames from FlexOC. In this video I'm going to assemble the frames and go over their features, and soon I'm going to feature at least two of them in build videos. The frames that I'm going to show you in this video are the new Ninja Trench, Normal and Butt version frames along with their 3D printed accessories, the Ascent X 5-inch racing frame, and the Kolugo frame that was shipped along with some extra arms, so using these parts I can build either the 3 or the 4-inch version. So now I'm going to quickly assemble everything together and I will see you in a bit in order to show you the results. Okay, so as you can see, now I've got everything assembled. First, let's start with the Ninja 3-inch frames. As you can see, the Ninja and the Ninja Bat are almost identical, and the only difference between the versions is that the Ninja Bat features these reinforced arms. In both versions, you can find a unibody button plate with a thickness of either 2, 2.5 or 3 mm. On the center of the frame, you can find multiple mounting options, so you can choose between 16x16, 20x20, and 25.5x25.5 mm whoop style mounting holes. The cage is also identical, and it's built to accommodate a micro-sized FPV camera, and as you can see, it can provide plenty of protection for the camera lens. You can also use multiple types of motor with this frame, so you can choose between 0.7x up to 11x motors. The thickness of the bottom plate of this Ninja Bat is 2 mm and weighs only 17.5 grams. So it's actually lighter than this Ninja frame, which has a bottom plate with a thickness of 3 mm and weighs 21.1 grams. On both versions, the width of each arm is 4.6 mm. The thickness of the side plates is 1.1 mm. The distance between the back motors and the front ones is about 85 mm. The distance between the back left motors and the right ones is about 85 mm as well, and the distance between the front two motors is about 125 mm. The wheelbase of the frame is about 135 mm, and the distance between the bottom plate to the bottom of the toe plate is 20.4 mm. A nice feature of this frame, which is going to be especially useful if you're going to use an FPV camera with HD recording capabilities, is that the camera is located away from the motors, so the propellers are not going to get into your view. So as far as I can tell, if you'd like to build a lightweight 3-inch quadcopter, both frames look like good options, and they can also be useful if you have a Beta 85X HD quadcopter, for example, and you broke your frame and you want to try something different. Moving on to the Kolugo frame. This frame has three versions. The one that I assembled features these bumpers, which are going to protect the 3-inch propellers, and this is useful for building a quadcopter that is intended for cinematic shots, so you can place a GoPro inside this 3D printed part and fly relatively safe close to objects. In addition to this version, you can also get 3 and 4-inch arms that do not offer the bumper option. The weight of the 3-inch bumper version is 67.3 grams, the thickness of the arms is 3 mm, the width is 10 mm, the thickness of the bumper plates is 2 mm, the thickness of the bottom plate and also the top one is 2 mm, the distance between the front motors and the back ones is 85 mm, The distance between the left motors and the right motors is about 125 mm. The wheelbase of the frame is about 150 mm. And the distance between the bottom plate and the top one is 20.4 mm. On the center of the plate, you can find a single 30x30 mount and plenty of holes that are going to enable you to place 20x20 boards in different positions. The distance between the first hole and the last one is 59 mm, so you can place two 20x20 boards or stacks next to each other. The battery is intended to be mounted on the top of the frame, and over here you can find holes for your battery strap. You should note that when you're buying this frame, you're not going to get the 3D printed parts, and you're going to need to either buy or 3D print these camera mounts, because otherwise you're not going to be able to mount an FPV camera. This mount is going to enable you to mount a micro-sized FPV camera, and you can also choose where to place it. So if you're going to put it over here, you're going to have plenty of protection, but of course you're going to see some of the frame. In addition, this part is made out of 3D printed TPU, so it's pretty flexible, and I actually managed to squeeze in a full-sized FPV camera. In terms of supported motors, you can use between 11OX up to 15OX motors, and in my experience, you should stick to either 13OX or 14OX motors, since 11OX motors are not going to be powerful enough, and 15OX motors are going to be too power hungry and drain your battery very fast. So from what I can tell so far, this frame is very interesting, and I'm going to feature it on one of my next build videos. Moving on to the Ascent X 5-inch racing frame. This frame offers a 3X pattern with a wheelbase of about 235 mm. It features robust replaceable arms with a thickness of 5 mm and width of about 7.8 mm. The thickness of the bottom plate is 1.7 mm. The thickness of the center plate is 2.5 mm. And the thickness of the side plates is 2.5 mm as well. On the center of the frame, you can find an X-shaped piece of carbon to prevent any arm movement. In addition, this frame offers both 20x20 and 30.5x30.5 mounting options. It supports 22OX motors. The distance between the bottom plate and the bottom of the side top plate is 33.8 mm, so you're going to easily be able to fit a three-level stack on the center of the quad. On the front of the frame, you're going to be able to fit a micro-sized FPV camera, and this frame offers the option to mount two of them. So for example, you can mount your FPV camera on the bottom and another HD recording camera next to it. Finally, the weight of the frame is 83.4 grams, so that's pretty light considering that it features replaceable arms with a thickness of 5 mm. You should note that FlexRC enables you to customize this frame, so first of all, you can get some extra arms, which is always recommended, so I recommend to get at least one extra arm in case you're getting this frame, and you can also get these supporting arms, so you're going to be able to mount them on the sides, on the front and on the back, or combine these options and use one on each side. This frame is a great candidate for a 6S build, and I'm going to feature it in the build video using the RC Inpower GTS V2 2207 Plus motors, which I've recently bench tested, and using the GapRC Span Pro tower, which I'm going to review in the next couple of days. As always, I thank you for watching my video, I hope you enjoyed it and you find it useful. If you have any questions about any of these frames, feel free to ask them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up if you like this video, and consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notifications bell if you're not already subscribed. See you on my next videos, and goodbye.